Your WordPress's site speed plays a critical role in its user experience. If your web pages have slow load times, not only can it affect your rankings, but it can also plummet your conversion rates. One of the best ways to improve server response times on your WordPress website is to focus on learning how to improve time to first byte, or TTFB. Reducing TTFB can help ensure that your site loads in visitors' browsers as quickly as possible, making it less likely that they'll abandon it. TTFB, or time to first byte, is the amount of time it takes for a browser to receive the first byte of data from a website's server. The faster your website's TTFB is, the better, because site resources and data will load and appear to visitors more quickly. TTFB is made up of three essential steps. First, the HTTP request is sent to the server, which can include a DNS lookup but varies based on the user's network and connection. The server processes the request and generates a response by communicating with network systems, running scripts, making database calls, etc. And finally, the server transmits the first byte of the response to the client, which marks the TTFB. So let's look at how to perform a TTFB test on your WordPress website. There are a few tools we recommend: Webpage Test, Pingdom Tools, GT Metrics, Key CDN Performance Test, and Chrome Dev Tools. For all these tools except Chrome Dev Tools, you need only visit their site and enter your URL. Oftentimes, you can enter in your location as well to get a more accurate result. These tools display different information, like an overall speed score and details about what pages and resources might be slowing down the site. But they will all include data on the TTFB as well. Note that many sites, like Pingdom and GT Metrics, will refer to it as wait time. Remember that network latency. Now, I mentioned just a moment ago that Chrome DevTools works a little bit differently, so let's walk through the steps to find the TTFB with Chrome DevTools. First, visit your WordPress website in a Chrome browser tab, and then click on the three vertical dots in the top right-hand corner to open the Chrome menu. Navigate to More Tools, Developer Tools, and under Network tab, you'll find a variety of metrics. In the Waterfall column, click on the element that you want to inspect and view the TTFB in the panel options. So now that we understand how to run a TTFB test, let's learn exactly how to improve TTFB for a WordPress website. We recommend using a plugin like WP Rocket to reduce the burden on your site's server, which will allow data to be transmitted and displayed faster. At WP Buffs, we use WP Rocket often to optimize the speed and performance of our client sites. You can also consider using a CDN, which will reduce the stress put on your server by offloading bandwidth consumption to its own data centers. This will help improve your TTFB score. The free Cloudflare CDN is a great option for this. You may have other CDN options available to you depending on your host. Next, you can try to optimize your WordPress database in order to reduce the bloating of your dynamic files and increase TTFB. If you're using the previously mentioned WP Rocket plugin, you can use its database optimization feature. DNS lookup times play a large role in TTFB. If you really want to go all out with improving it, look at a premium DNS provider like Amazon Route 53, which will help immensely with those lookup times. Plugins, while amazingly powerful, can also cause a lot of bloat, which slows down your site. A simple and quick way to reduce TTFB is to trim any unnecessary, unused, or inactive plugins from the site. And finally, if none of these other options work for you, consider upgrading your WordPress hosting in order to improve TTFB. Consider upgrading the plan that you have, or switch to a different host altogether. Your host is going to determine which and how many server locations you can leverage, which affects speed. Avoid shared hosting plans, and stick with managed WordPress hosting if you can.